What's up, everybody? I'm Eric Devante, and you're watching MajorFilmEvents.com. Today, I'm at the Holly Shores Film Festival for the last night, which is also awards night. So this is the night that we find out which filmmakers will go home with the coveted prizes. I'm very excited. Make sure you stay tuned to MajorFilmEvents.com. All right, guys, I'm reunited with an old friend tonight, the creator of Girl P Sitting Down. How are you feeling?
I'm great. I feel very happy to be here.
Now, I was just telling you that you have to take this moment in because tonight is about you and your work. How do you feel about that?
I feel really happy that P Sitting Down screened so well last night. Everyone was laughing. We got big laughs, ton of laughs, and they liked the kind of raunchy, weird, dark humor. So I'm just so happy that dark humor can find a place with a commercial audience.
Oh yeah, I love dark humor and I love raunchiness. Raunchiness makes the party so much more fun. And we were talking about your dating life because that was such a huge part of the inspiration behind this show. So how has that been?
Well, you know, funny enough, here at the festival, I actually met a very handsome young man through a friend, organically, not online, which was very confusing for me. I had to quickly re-educate myself in how people were meant to meet each other. But it went great. He came to the screening and we had a lovely night together. So
you know what? It's good to know that there are other ways to connect with people outside of online dating because I've been trying and it's not working. So you give me hope.
You have the ultimate in. I mean, you've got like a speed dating operation going here.
This is true. You know what? You've just given me hope and hopefully tonight at the film festival I can find love. You know, I have a question for you. How would you feel about doing a short series about a young gay boy in Los Angeles?
I think it's great. I can be your pimp.
I've always wanted a pimp. My mom is going to be so proud. She's going to be so happy about this. It's going to be great. Well, congratulations, and I hope you have a great night tonight.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Cameo, you have a wonderful film in the festival, so I want you to share with the audience what your film is about and how the inspiration came about for this amazing film.
My film is Real Artists, and the inspiration came from a short story by an author named Ken Liu. It was published in MIT's Technology Review. I read it, I optioned it, and then I decided to make it.
Now, you optioned this. How did that happen? Because we need to find out the details behind you getting this fabulous story.
So I was reading the story on a plane on Virgin, and then once we hit 10,000 feet, I got on Wi-Fi, emailed Ken because I found his email address online, and about 20 minutes after I emailed him saying, hey, could I option this? He said, yes, of course. This sounds great. So it's really easy.
That's the power of a woman getting on her email and optioning this film, and she got a call back and is like, yes. The casting choices you made, so talk about the casting because I love the poster you did and the actress is beautiful.
Yes.
So talk to me about that.
So the very first person we cast was actually Tamlyn Tamita. You might know her from the Joy Luck Club, and she was also in Karate Kid Part 2. It's her very first role, and she was also in Four Rooms with Antonio Banderas. She's been in so many amazing things. So she was the very first person I contacted, and sort of like Ken Liu, she immediately replied back. I said, yes, of course, I love the script, I love everything you're doing, I want to be in your movie. So that was so easy. And then the second person was Tiffany Hines. She was much, much harder to find, but you know, once we clicked over Game of Thrones and that we both loved it, she was like, yes, I want to be in your movie, you respect Game of Thrones, Sunday nights are off. So yeah, it was great.
Cameo has all the tricks how to get your film made. I think we need to make sure you call her at the end of this interview. So Cameo, this is a really impactful, you know, the storyline is really important because this kind of stuff can happen. What's the political statement, or I want to say the social statement behind your film, if there is one?
Sure. I mean, I think that the social statement might be that, you know, corporations can sometimes get out of control in terms of the things that they're willing to do in order to make money. It also talks about what we're willing to do as filmmakers to quantify our success. Like, what would we be willing to do to say, I want to guarantee an 89% success rate critically or Academy Award possibility for my film? And am I willing to give up most of the creative direction in order to get those numbers?
I really like Cameo. So, how do we find you and stay in touch with you on social media?
So, my social media is Real Artists Film, and that's on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. And then our website is realartists.film. And you'll also be able to find all of our screenings and trailer on there as well.
Everybody check out Cameo's film, and we will see much more of Cameo. And thank you so much for being with us tonight at the fabulous Holly Shores Film Festival.
Thank you.
What's going on, everybody? I have short series creator Tamara with me. How are you feeling tonight?
I am feeling awesome. I'm super excited.
Yes. Now, Tamara, can you tell us a bit about your short series?
Sure. I made a series called Van Diaries, and it is a show about a minivan. It's a comedy. about all the different owners, forwards and backwards through time, that have owned this 1999 Dodge Grand Caravan in Palms, Los Angeles.
Now, Tamara, do you have a van?
I don't, but my really good friend Matt does.
Okay, that's good.
Yes, and Matt is the inspiration of the show and also the lead actor on the show, my co-star.
So what made you feel like this was it? I want to talk about this van.
Okay, so Matt is just a really cool, funny, interesting actor guy that's been rolling around in this van for 15 years. So we just talked about it, and I said, I just want to make a show about your van and all the people that probably had it. And oh, there goes the producer right now.
Look at that. Come, look at this plug.
Oh, are you bringing drinks?
Look at the producer bringing drinks. Nothing like good gifts.
That's producing right there. It's all about supplying the alcohol so that people get the job done.
Part of the reason why entertainment keeps going. Alcohol is a huge part of that, too.
Thank our sponsor, Deep Eddie Vodka, for the party tonight.
That's perfect. So what would you say was the most fun part of creating this series?
It's a comedy. So
it's working with friends, I think, is the best part. Is we have the talented friends, and to get to do something with them and work together. I mean, what's better than working with friends? You know?
You guys seem like very good friends to have, because I went to your event last night, and let me say, you know how to throw a party.
Yeah, we had a little after party, and we brought the friends. So we brought the band.
The work's important, but more important is the party.
It is. Work hard, play hard.
Work hard, play hard.
And I wanted to shout out this outfit. I love the sheer top to go with the sheer lace around the shoes. You know how to get it done. I'm loving this.
Thank you, Allison Olivia, BCBG, my wonderful stylist, makeup artist, Laura Garcia. Hi, thank you.
I love it. Now, Tamara, what's your social media handle so we can keep up with it?
Bye, Gary. At Tamara Garfield on everything, or at Van Diaries.
Well, congratulations, and I look forward to seeing more from you.
Yes, get some VD in LA.
Perfect. So what film are you ladies representing tonight?
The Room Actors, Where Are They Now?
Oh, perfect. Can you talk a bit about the inspiration behind that film?
Yes, it's based on this movie, The Room, which is has a cult following all over the world. It's known as the Citizen Kane of bad movies. So what we did is we brought the original actors from the movie The Room together, 7 out of 9 of them, and we did a fictionalized Where Are They Now. So it's a mockumentary about what happened to these people after they were in the worst movie ever made.
It's the same film that James Franco is doing The Disaster Artist at. So our show is actually what happened to the actual actors. It's a mockumentary, kind of best of show type series, and his actually is about what happened during the making of the film, which we think is kind of hilarious that that's happening right now.
Yeah. That's a horrible thing to be remembered for, being a part of the worst movie ever. How did they feel being a part of it?
It was the first acting job when I came to LA. I was a small part in The Room. I played Michelle. And so I brought the actual actors together, and I think a lot of them have felt sort of like just dragged along with the film, and they kind of wanted to reclaim a little dignity. And so that's kind of partially why I did this project, to give them a chance to redeem themselves, all of us, and to show that they could be funny, they could poke fun at themselves, and we're all in on the joke. So that
was,
yeah, that was it.
How would you say that they were able to redeem themselves with this one?
I think so. I think it's very, I'm biased. I wrote and directed it, but
it's hard when you've made the product, the project, but it is, I think they have taken back some of their dignity and kind of shown that they know how bad it is. And then, had a lot of fun with, there are a lot of inside jokes with the film. People go to these midnight screenings all over the world and throw spoons at the screen and dress up and toss footballs in the audience. And so we've actually given new life to those actors in their own stories, but also we pay homage to what everybody loves about The Room. So.
Well, when was the film originally made?
It came out in 2003. So it's been, 14 years. Yeah. So it's been a while, and it's grown slowly over time, and then Entertainment Weekly sort of jumped on it, and a lot of celebrities kind of became fans, and then it just grew and grew and grew, and now it literally shows all over the world, Australia, you're all over Europe, even South America, it's screening. Back. Everyone likes the Hollywood comeback, right?
We've got 7 comebacks in this. We got 7 of the original actors from The Room in the series, and we've shot 3 episodes, and we're going to be releasing, we can't tell you where yet, but we're going to be releasing soon and on a distribution avenue. But so we have 7 of the original actors from the movie in this series, and it's I mean, I'm biased. I didn't write it or direct it. I just produced. So I will say I'm biased because I came on board, but I think it's hilarious. So, yeah.
Well, do you ladies have any social media that you want to share with us?
Sure. Our Twitter and Instagram is at The Room Actors. Our website is theroommockumentary.com. Our Facebook is Mockumentary also. So follow us. You'll hear updates about when we're going to release probably in November, but we'll tell you where if you follow us on social media. And
Sounds good. Well, congratulations, ladies, and have a great night.
Well, of course, we want to know the name of the film and what's your film about.
So the film is Blood Brothers. It's about a British soldier who deserts his battalion and finds a wounded German soldier in a barn. And it takes place during World War I.
Yeah. And I need to know the inspiration behind this film.
Yeah, so history has always been a passion of mine, especially World War I, just because of the disillusionment during that time period. And I was just thinking about, I'm only 21 years old. I was 20 when I made the film, so that's only a year off from the average soldier's age during that time period. And I was just thinking about what it would be like to be a soldier 100 years ago during World War I and where I would fit in all of that. And I kind of got to the conclusion that I might desert and what that would mean and how I would survive. And kind of that's what I dealt with when I was writing the film.
How much research did you have to do? Because you have to go through all the archives and look at the pictures and lives. And how did that help you? What kind of research? How long did it take you?
I would say when I came up with the idea, I spent a month kind of in intense research. I've always loved the period, so I kind of know the poetry and the history of it all, but I actually got really hooked on Dan Harmon's Hardcore History, which is a great podcast about that kind of thing. And then the photos, I got a bunch of books from different art stores and really got invested with that, and it really helped kind of get into the right mindset.
And having the right producer is very important. So how did you come on board for the project?
Well, I was through all stages. I got the first draft of the script, and I'm still here all the way through distribution. Yeah, that's kind of life of the short film producer. But what I was going to add to that last question, we went through a lot to make sure that the time period and the film was very factually correct. We actually had a military technical advisor on set at all times that made sure that everything, even to the costumes, the helmets, we actually used real World War I
bayonets.
Yeah. We actually trained our actors too to be soldiers and act like soldiers in World War I. So we went through a lot of time to make sure that it was as perfect.
Period pieces are tough, you know? I mean, every detail does matter when you think about it.
It's interesting because this is my first film, and they always say, for any film, they're like, don't do war and don't do a period piece. And I was
did exactly that.
I was like, let's just try it out. So I did it. It was a great challenge, though. It was very, very fun. I couldn't have done it without my producer, my production designer, my DP, but especially the costume designer, Gabby Acosta. She did amazing work. We worked with Eastern Costume. Some of the uniforms were actually from the time period, salvaged. But we really left no stone unturned. We really went the distance with it. Yeah.
Well, we need social media for the film and for both you guys, so tell us what that is.
Yeah, so Blood Brothers social media, so Instagram and Twitter, Blood Bros Movie. Facebook is Blood Brothers Movie. And then my personal Instagram handle is Nicole Falsetti. And
My personal Instagram is Max Chernoff. And then the website for the film is bloodbrothersshort.com.
Congratulations, guys. I can't wait to see the film.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Guys, I had an amazing time at the Holly Shores Film Festival, but sadly, tonight's the last night. Make sure you stay tuned to majorfilmevents.com. You never know where we'll be next.